Ghost Hunting in New England,
your favorite spooky podcast. Hey guys, happy Wednesday and welcome to Ghost Hunting in New England with your hosts Amelia
and Beth.
And today we're doing something so fun. So we realized we have said for the last two episodes, oh, next week we'll do the drive-by ghostings. Next week we'll do the drive-by ghostings. We were like, why not just do an entire episode of drive-by ghostings? So that's what we're here for today.
This should be super fun. We have audio files that people recorded and sent to us. We have all these sheets of paper all printed out that we're going to read some stories off of. Amelia has found some really incredibly spooky music to play while we're reading the stories. It should be great fun for everybody.
Yeah, we think this is just a fun thing. A lot of these came from paranormal investigators. Some of them just came from people sharing their own ghost story. And we even got one all the way from India, which is so exciting and cool. We're so happy.
Did you know we had people in India?
No.
I had no idea either.
Did you know we have people in Australia?
I did not know that, but we don't have a story from people in Australia, sadly, yet. They're going to send it to us.
We're going to have an Australian story next week. We were promised one, so we can't wait for that. And hello to everyone in the UK, which we found out we have a lot of listeners over there, but none of you submit stories, so yeah, maybe next week.
Yeah, we're always in the market for your drive-by ghosting stories. And if you were wondering if your story is the type of story for a drive-by ghosting, you're going to find out tonight what other people are submitting. So you should have a pretty good model after tonight.
Let's just say if you're wondering if it's the right type of story for a drive-by ghosting, it absolutely is. It absolutely is. Okay, next story. So this next story comes to us from our good friends over in India. Beth, do you want to tell us a little bit about what we're going to hear in this one?
I do. Because it is from India and the speaker does have a heavy accent, I just want to kind of fill in a couple of the things, kind of front load you with some information going in here. The first is that this is going on in 2017 in Calcutta, India. There are some objects moving and some chairs moving around, and the speaker here talks about using his spirit box, his EVP recorder, and his K2 meter.
Also, he sprinkles powder on the floor to see if there are any footsteps that go through.
Yes, he does. So then the client that he's going and meeting with is concerned that they're having some hallucinations. So he's going to talk a little bit about that as well. But I just wanted to put that out there in case you're having any sort of difficulty understanding him. Your other option, of course, is to always back it up and listen to it a second time. But it's a really interesting story.
Yeah, and this is from one of the investigators for, and I'm sure I'm saying this wrong, but I'm going to try to say it, Batanagar Paranormal Society, and you spell that Batanagar Paranormal Society, because at one point he's going to tell you he has a lot of this recorded on his YouTube channel, so you can go there and check it out.
Well, thank you for giving me the chance to share my experience with you guys all. I just want to share one of them, which is really impressive and never forgettable event, actually. It was 2017. We got a case from Khordha, Kolkata. After got the case, it's quite interesting that client claimed that in their house, there are some paranormal activities happened, like object movement and also some footsteps and so on. So finally, when we get that case, and we thought that visit the client place, obviously. And after that, when we trying to communicate with that space by echo box or by some EVPs, we cannot find anything more than 1 hour. But after that, 1.5 hour, we got some response on our K2 meters, which is used for as EMF measurement, and also got some EVP recording. Like in their house, actually, what happened? The client claimed that their grandma is alive even after her death. She doing this kind of paranormal activities like object movements, chair movements, footsteps, and sometimes full body appearance. When we trying to communicate with that space or with the grandma, we got some EVPs, some intelligent EVPs. Obviously, it's like a class A EVP. And when we ask that if you know that you are dead, then can you please confirm that what's your grandchild name? And the answer is came, and the perfect and the class A EVP, I must say. And the next thing, when we trying to communicate with EMF or K2 meter, we got some spikes. Obviously, it's intelligent because it's happened only after our command. There are two places, there are two bedrooms, and This all happened in one bedroom, but the next bedroom, which is, you know, quite impressive and really interesting, which is not memorable. As we as client claimed that in their house they feel some footsteps like this kind of things, so we try to use powder on the floor and call the spirits or provoke or the challenge the spirits to come here and give some signs of your presence. After 3 to 4 minutes, we got two, you know, full leg, footprint on our powder, which is really impressive. And this video, obviously, in our YouTube channel, you guys can watch that video and let me know, or let us know, that what's your point of view in this case. And it's really memorable. And after that, when the client understand that yes, there has no any hallucination or, you know, psychological disorder, this is real paranormal activity, they understand that, oh yes, they appreciate with us about their presence and respect. When we try to say that you guys are comfortable with or you guys agree with the clean sign, and they say no, we like our grandmother presence and we don't want to mess up with these kind of things, so we said okay and leave that place. So that's the great experience we have ever seen in my life during the investigation. This is footprint case. So thank you guys. Hope you guys enjoyed. Thank you.
Freaking sweet.
Mm.
We got an in from India. That's so cool. Thank you so much for sending that in. That was awesome and informative.
Yes, thank you.
We love the similarity. Like, ghost hunting is going on all over the world.
Mm-hmm. And they asked a question that you have also asked in some of your EVPs, which was, do you know you're dead?
Yes.
And so after that, he talked a little bit about he was only able to get spikes on his K2 meter after answering questions.
Yep.
Or after asking questions. So, mm-hmm. like, how? I don't know that we've ever tried to get responses to questions with a K2 meter. I think that every time we've done it, it's been we were just recording with our EVP recorder, but we didn't, like, have the K2 meter out at the same time. That could be something that we might try in the future.
Yes.
So I feel like that's another thing that we get from these drive-by ghostings, is that, like, if we hear from other investigators, we can always get new ideas, and hopefully people are getting ideas from us as well.
Yeah. Oh, my gosh. That was so great. I'm so happy. So just to give everyone a little teaser, too, kind of related. Earlier today, and we're not going to talk about it except for a little bit right now on tonight's episode, but we will talk about it on a future episode. We actually had a footprint today that we found.
Yes. And so it was stunning to hear this particular recording talking about footprints in the powder, when earlier today we saw what was clearly a child's footprint in no powder, but it was,
but
like,
the footprint was the powder.
It was strange, and it was in a place where there would not be children,
not barefoot children, that's for sure.
And there were no other foot. There was just this one footprint.
One footprint. It's as if someone dipped their one foot in flour, took one step, and that was it.
Flew over, dropped their foot in that one step, and then flew.